Children, today we will discuss about the chapter heat in class 7. So heat, everyone knows that in our daily life we are seeing that temperature and the heat. These two terms are related to each other. But before going into the difference and the relation between these two, heat and temperature, first of all we must know about the term heat. Heat is actually the term related to the energy. It is related to energy. That every matter has some kind of energy. There are various forms of energy, among which the heat is also one form of energy. But how the heat is different from other form of energy? If a form of energy which gives the sensation of hotness or coldness, it gives the sensation of hotness or coldness. That is known as heat. So simply we can define the heat. Heat is the form of energy which gives sensation of hotness or coldness. That is heat. And this heat, we will discuss elaborately by taking the energy possessed by that matter. Energy possessed by that matter, that means earlier I said all the matter possesses energy. So to discuss this, just we take two containers in which water is taken. Container, it is A. Water is filled in this container up to some level. And another container, that is labeled as B, that also filled in the water. But these two waters are in different state. Different state means these two waters having energy, but the energy possessed by these two waters is not same. So this is general. All the matter are having energy, but the energy possessed by every matter which gives hotness or coldness is not same. In this, we take the two containers. The water in container may have the greater energy than the water in container B. Whenever anything has greater energy, we say that body, that object, here we are taking the water, and that is hot. And the container which is having water is having less energy than A. Then we say that water is cold. Therefore, this is hot water and this one is cold water. If the water is hot, then the energy possessed by that particle is having greater energy. It is having greater energy. Here, lesser energy. So, the two things. Objects may have greater energy or less energy. If it is hot, it has greater energy. If it is cold, it has less energy. Then in this, how can we say anything is hot, anything is cold? Here I said it is having greater energy, it is having less energy. Now the question arises with respect to what? It is having greater energy and this one is having less energy. For this, we need some reference. That reference may be anything. Here we are going to take our body part as the reference. That body part is our hands. Now, I put my hand in these two containers. Left hand on one container, right hand on another container. Suppose if I put this, if I take this is the hand, this is right hand, and here it is left hand. So in this, when we put these two hands in two different containers, one is containing hot water, another one is containing cold water. So the right hand feels hotter and the left hand feels colder. It is because our body, that is our hand, is also having energy. And the energy possessed by our body and the hot water, energy possessed by our body and the cold water are not same. They are different. Here we see that the right hand is feeling hotter. It is because the energy of particles in water, hot water, is greater than the energy possessed by our hand. So in this case, we feel hotter. The left hand feels colder. It is because the energy possessed by cold water, the energy of particles possessed by cold water, is less than the energy possessed by our hand. That's why we feel cold in the left hand. And why do we feel hot or cold? This is because of difference in energy. And how this hotness or coldness is felt? Because the energy is having one property, special property, that the energy can flow from one level to another level. That is the flow of energy. Energy can flow from one level to another level. That is obviously, it is from higher level to lower level. Higher level to lower level, the energy always flows. This is its basic nature. Here also the hotness felt by right hand and coldness felt by left hand is due to the flow of energy from one level to another level. The right hand is feeling hotness. It is because the energy is flowing from the water to our hand. That's why we feel hotness. And the left hand feels cold. It is because the energy from our hand flows to the water. That's why we feel cold. So, the hotness and coldness, it is basically due to the flow of energy from one body to another body. And we take ourselves, our body feels hotter when we take the energy, when we receive energy from the surrounding. We feel cold when we lose the energy from our body. That is, during summer season, we feel hot. It is because our energy is receiving from the surrounding. And we feel cold during winter season because the energy flows from our body to the surrounding. That's why we feel cold. That is the hotness and the coldness that we feel in our daily life. And this hotness and coldness is also related to the temperature.